Hey guys, this is Duel Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links. I used to play Yu-Gi-Oh! All the time when I was like real little. So I thought this would be a good sphere. Hit. Probably look at the opening credits, I guess. If you can't tell by my voice, what's going on here is I'm in deep nostalgia, cause it has been so long since I played this in real life, and so long since I have played like a game based off of this. So when I was first getting into it, it was this gigantic mystery to me. I had no idea how to play this game while I was playing it. Like, I played it, I figured out the rules, but it was still like, every couple of games, I'd be like, what the fuck? You can't do that. You can do that? No! You did that! What the hell? You get what I'm saying? Like, I'd be so confused. And then at some point, I got, like, everything flipped on it. Like, I had no idea. I don't think that ever went away with this game. Like, when you're starting out and you're new and stuff, that's okay to experience. You know, you don't know what's gonna happen. It makes the game exciting. That never stopped with this game, though. There was never a point where I suddenly became the expert on, like, even, like, me becoming the expert on my own deck. No, that never happened. I never got over the, like, any of it. It always remained as this elusive rule system that I could never fully grasp. Cause even when I thought I knew what I was doing, here comes this one card that bugs all my perception of it, of the entire game. He twists it on its head. That little guy is a cheater. Like, that's something I absolutely 100% remember from the show, is that every freaking duel he does, he cheats like in a million different ways. All of them do that. Like, every person playing the game on the show, they all cheat in a thousand different ways, but Yugi is the worst. Okay? Like, Yugi is the absolute worst when it comes to that. That was my shit. I had that card and I loved that card. That was my, like, I crushed so many people with Lava Guardian.
Lava Guardian, what was it?
Yeah, Lava Guardian, I think. That was my shit, though. Freaking love that. Like, you could brought Lava Guardian out on the field, and it was like, oh shit, I guess I lose. This is fucking nuts. Like, back when me and my brother played this, that was my shit too. I love Relinquish X. Cause he's such a weird card. Like, if you played him right, it was so weird to play him right. Was weird. To play him wrong got you killed, but to play him right was weird. Anyway. I think the last time I actually played this was playing with my little sister. Sister, I wouldn't hold back, and neither would she, because Yu-Gi-Oh's a game in which that is not an option, you know? Like, it's not this type of game where you can hold back. No, you play the cards you're able to play. You make the attacks you're able to make. You set the traps and the plans in motion that you're able to set in motion. If you're not able to set them in motion, then you're not able to set them in motion. But if you are, you do. You get what I'm saying? Like, there is no holding back in this because it's not really ran by you. It's ran by the rules and the cards in your hand, and you just have to be able to see what you're able to do. Now with this game, as opposed to like the pre-made decks that you buy in the store, this game you're gonna have infinite possibilities of what your deck could be. So I mean, we're gonna have to figure stuff out as we go. It's no longer going to be like that in this game because, and that's the difference between in real life and a computer game or in a console game. In real life, you have to get money to get more cards, blah blah blah, or you could use a pre-made deck that already has stuff set up to where it works. But in the games like this and on the consoles and everything, you've got the, you know, 200, maybe 500, I have no idea how many cards, you know, score, you've got a set number of cards that you can obtain. And after that, it's on you to figure out how to set up everything. I want to go get a drink, but I'm not gonna just leave the video running with nothing going on, you know? I'm not that much of a goof. I started this, I can finish this. I figure by the time this video ends, it'll be all downloaded and stuff. Then I can go get a drink. I also love the design and the artwork of the cards in the show. Because they do put a lot of, you know, thought and a lot of care and detail and everything. You can tell that somebody worked really hard to design everything about it. Down to minute detail. Story of the show? Not so much. But the game, how it works, all the other stuff, so on and so forth. I mean, yeah. I've never liked the stories of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Shows, though. I think mainly because Yugi never did anything for him. Like, it took him a long time to do anything for himself. Yugi Moto or whatever. Mainly it was the namesake of the show, Yu-Gi-Oh, who did freaking everything for that kid. And I get it, two main characters, whatever, main character in his tag along, but so, I don't know, but like, it was like split personality disorder with a mystical artifact explanation. If you get what I'm saying. Like, in between the duels, what we got was Yugi Moto. And that was kind of the strength of his character, was interacting with people. But whenever, and I mean whenever, they went into a duel, there comes Yu-Gi-Oh! Out to the first thing. Not when Yugi needed him to bail him out of the situation, which is what it started as. That's what it started as. But eventually it just got to the point where Yugi was doing the card game, and or Yu-Gi-Oh! Was doing the card game, and Yugi did everything else. You get what I'm saying? And I just felt like that, like, in spoilers, the show ended with Yugi beating Yu-Gi-Oh. I don't know if that's where it ended, but that's something I remember happened, like, really late in the show, is Yugi beats Yu-Gi-Oh in a card duel, and I'm just like, when, how, where, what? Like, there's no way that Yugi, who doesn't even really play the game anymore, who was a passenger with Yu-Gi-Oh! Throughout all those games, somehow retained enough skill and learned and became better than the person he was watching play. If any of that makes sense. Like, there's just no way. But apparently it happened. You know, I can sit here and say there's no way all day, but that's how the story went. You know, fact. I don't like disputing fact, but it happened, and I thought it shouldn't have. Which is something that always seems to happen in cartoons and anime and any story, is when the good guy beats the bad guy. And I don't want to say that I would be a bad guy, but I feel like I would be I'm a realist when it comes to this. It's, you know, silver doesn't beat gold. Gold doesn't beat platinum. Or better yet, let me put it this way. Bronze doesn't beat platinum. Freaking normal doesn't beat platinum. This does not happen. Otherwise, there is no point in calling platinum platinum. Might as well all be no bronze, no gold. You know what I'm saying? And that's where I find the trouble of just... But... I guess... If you throw a baby into a pack of wolves, they're... 500 times. Like, you go out, you get 500 babies, you keep throwing the babies into the bag of wolves, and the bag of wolves keeps eating the babies. Eventually, you're gonna get that one baby who kills the pack of wolves. And even though that sounds idiotic as a, you know, theory, and everybody would be like, no, the pack of wolves gonna kill all 500 babies, blah, blah, blah. That's why when that one baby out of 500 kills the pack of wolves, it's brutal, it's badass, and it's awesome. Now, I do not support doing this, neither should anyone do this. I was using that as a theoretical example. Please do not feed wolf babies. Okay. We might get 10 minutes of gameplay out of this after all, out of the 30-minute video. Are you cringing yet? You know, hand, forehead in your hands going, no, no, no. I remember... There was a sub-series of Yu-Gi-Oh! That I absolutely loved, and I loved it more than Yu-Gi-Oh! Itself, called Capsule Monsters. The idea behind it was, you know those, and you've probably seen them at the grocery store, at least that's where I remember seeing them. Where you would put the two quarters in and you would get a toy out or you would get gum out or something along those lines. Yeah, you would get it's one of those machines, but instead you get capsule monsters, which are these capsules, and then you open them up and there's the monster, and it's a Yu-Gi-Oh card monster. But it's a different game. With these little 3D model toys. Right? Okay. I freaking loved that idea. I loved it so goddamn. Like, in my head, that made absolutely perfect sense, and I still don't know why that doesn't exist in America. I'm sure it exists somewhere, but it's not America. Just at the grocery store or somewhere else, just this machine roll three models that are part of this game that we can play. I thought it would be cool if, if you had, like, your personal one. And then you fight, depending on certain things, either won or lost. Like, you got equipment for it, like an action figure. Not like the little 3D models that don't move at all, but like an action figure toy. And then the real game would be customizing it to where it's completely unique. And then, depending on when we lose, you either won or lost, and that was tracked, and it made your things, your little guy stronger. I thought that would be cool, you know? And that's what a lot of MMOs and RPGs do. But it would be cool as like a card game or a board game or something. With this little action figure. Or maybe you could have multiple. No. There's a lot of ideas like that. That's kind of a vague version of a lot of other things, I think. I used to play the card game.
Let's see if you have the cards to challenge me,
Kaiba. I cannot afford to lose.
We'll go, Yugi. We got 7 minutes. Let's go. There we go.
Kaiba! I will defeat you!
I will defeat you once and for all. Duel! It's my turn. Watch closely. I summon a monster in attack position.
Oh, shit. There we go.
I end my turn.
It's my turn. I draw a card.
Okay.
Here I go. I summon a monster in attack position.
This is by far the coolest tutorial on one of these types of games.
Time to battle. Playtime is over. I attack with a monster.
You'll have to do better than that.
Cool. Carryover damage. I forgot about that.
My turn is done.
Get ready. My turn. I end my turn.
It's my turn. I draw a card.
Oh shoot, it's Dark Magician. Okay. This is the part that always fucking confused me, is the level number of the starting card 5 or higher. The summon monsters that are 5 or higher more than 15 monsters and the PM has to be 15. The summon monsters. Oh, and the number
companion
stars they have to do is 5 or higher. Yeah, Dark Magician.
Time to battle.
This thing is gonna kill Kaiba.
Go, Dark Magician! Dark Magic Attack!
Well, that was a fast one.
I was willing to risk everything, Kaiba.
Kaiba, you're a bitch. That's the dual demo. Okay. Oh, okay. We're using a level 1, level 1 Yugi Mojo. Screw it.
True duelist, I expect nothing.
I'm gonna win your duel.
My turn. I draw a card. My hand. I activate a spell. Set this card face down. I end my turn.
My turn. Battle. Do it. My monster will take you down.
It's not whether you win or lose.
Okay, that's it for episode 1. See you guys later. Remember to have fun. I'm gonna grab a drink, and then I'm gonna be back, press the button, and start the next episode. See you guys.